It's Emily's Leah. I'm coming to you from a brand new camera, so hopefully the settings have worked. I should be in a little bit more kind of HD, so to speak. You can see every wrinkle, every line, every alcohol-induced thread vein. It's awesome. Nice. Now, if you're sick of using your hands to get into Pogo like a peasant, then have I got a trick for you today. So I thought today we'd have a go at doing a pop to Pogo. So this one you can use as a bit of a different variation rather than having to use your hands to pull up into the trick. There's loads you can do out of it. There's quite a lot of scope for variation. So hopefully this one should be super fun. In terms of difficulty, it's not a super hardcore trick, but it's also not the easiest. So you're going to want to be really comfortable getting up into Pogo. And you want to be quite comfortable kind of getting out of that as well with different tricks. So let's take a look at it and see if we can get it done. Let's have some fun. Now, one thing you'll notice, that board is coming perilously close to a very private area. So what you need to think about with this one is the length of your board. If you've got a shorter freestyle board, then that's good. Try and go for one that, you know, that will spare your nether regions. Okay. Now we're going to need a fairly strong pop for this one. What we're doing is we're kind of using the pressure to pop the board upwards, and then catching the board between our feet and the pogo. Okay. So with your foot position, your back foot wants to be just on the tail, nice and solid, kind of pretty much like you would do for an ollie. And your front foot wants to be right up on the nose. You don't really want it hanging off the edge too much, just comfortably on the nose should be all good for you. Now the idea here is to really get the power from the back foot. So you're going to compress, bend your knees a bit, ready to release that pressure in your feet. So you're going to pop off the tail, and as soon as you've released that pressure, you're going to slide that front foot off the edge of the board, and then bring it straight back in to catch that truck. Cool, so as soon as we pop on the tail, what we want to do is slide that front foot up and off the nose, okay? So that pressure with the back foot is going to bring the board up, and because you've built up that pressure in your knees, then sliding that front foot off is going to bring the board upwards. Then you're locking the front foot onto this truck, so onto your back truck. Now, something to bear in mind, this might batter your legs a little bit when you're learning it, because the truck itself is probably going to hit your shins a little bit, but that's all good. If you can do, don't know if you can see it there on the camera, but you'll see my kingpin here is super low. If you've got a set of trucks with a low kingpin like that, that's going to help. But for the time being, if you need to wear some kind of pad or something like that, a shin pad, God forbid, then you can do. That's going to stop it hitting your shins quite as much. Cool. So as soon as you've released that pressure, be ready to catch that truck and use your other foot here to catch the board, just like you would in a normal pogo. So you pop, push that front foot out to let the board flip up, then bring both feet in. So you're almost ninja kicking it out and then pulling the legs back together to catch it, okay? Make sure you catch it nice and solid, otherwise you can sometimes land with your feet on the wheels. So you're kind of landing here rather than here. So make sure you bring that foot in. When you're booting that front foot out, if you want to go for some style points, yeah, get a full extension on it, but start off just by pushing the foot out a little bit so it's easier to bring it back in. Just make sure that you're giving the board enough clearance to pop upwards. So if you're struggling with that that basic movement, that pop, then a good way to try it is just stand on your board on flat ground. I'm gonna grab my board. Stand on your board on the flat, and just get used to popping that front foot off and keeping the back foot on and going up into a tail stop. What you'll find is that the board's coming up pretty high, so that'll get you used to how much pressure you're going to need. The main thing is to jump off that back foot a little bit once you've released the front, so you're kind of popping like an ollie but shoving the front foot off essentially. Then of course, once you're up in the pogo, it's entirely up to you what you want to do to get back out of it. In my opinion, pogos are quite a hard trick to make look really good. But this trick helps because it just gives it that bit of something different. It's a little bit more technical rather than just pulling up or scooping it up with one foot and then getting your hands on it. So it's a super fun one to try. There's loads of different variations for this one. So you can, if you want to, try and do this fakie. Fakie is actually easier because you're travelling backwards. The pop and the pressure on that back foot automatically wants to bring the board upwards and vertical. So it actually does feel a lot easier doing it in fakie. Problem is, you've got to be prepared for the landing because it's going to keep you travelling backwards. So make sure that you hop with it, and hop if you're regular to your right hand side if you're going fakie, or if you're goofy over to your left. So hop in the direction in which the board is travelling. Cool. So start them off stationary, get used to the movement of it, and then progress it up to fakie if you want to. Hopefully all that makes sense. You'll soon find that it's just about using the right amount of pressure in your feet and getting the timing right with that front foot. Back foot doesn't have to do a huge amount here. Remember, it's going to be easier on a freestyle board. If you don't have a freestyle board, you can do it on a street deck, but just be prepared. It could chomp your nose and tail up a bit, but also that bit of extra length could maim you in rather a personal fashion, if that makes sense. Cool, so thanks very much for dropping by. Hope you like the trick tip. If you have any questions, you just give me a shout in the comments. I'll do my best to help you out. If there's other tricks you want to see, let me know. There'll be a few of these coming up. And of course, if you liked what you saw, give us a like. Share it around your mates, anyone who might be learning to skate freestyle. And give us a subscribe for some more freestyle skateboarding footage videos. Things that you can basically watch, listen to, and in some cases, smell and taste. Rad, go skate. Go on, get on it.